Food insecurity is defined as limited or uncertain access to adequate food, with nearly 1 in 4 households experiencing food insecurity during the pandemic. And a Northwestern study found that food insecurity has more than tripled among households with kids. That means that parents and their children are going hungry in a country where over 100 billion pounds of food is wasted every year. That's nearly 40% of all food in America. The issue isn't a lack of food, it's a lack of access to the food. Meanwhile, over 90% of Americans have a cell phone. That was where Not Impossible, an incubator dedicated to solving real-world problems through technology, came up with the idea for Bento. Bento is a text message-based platform that helps connect people in need of food with prepaid meals at local restaurants and grocery stores. It's currently in 8 cities and has supplied over 150,000 meals in its first year to people through enterprise partners like Santa Monica College, the Boys and Girls Club of America, and the VA. And over next year, the company is aiming to serve 1 million meals. I spoke with the founders of Bento on my World Changing Ideas podcast about their vision.
This is such an urgent problem. Can you talk a little bit about your partnership with Genpact and whether that helped quicken the process in this case?
In just our pilot cities, we're close to 150,000 meals served, all through this frictionless system that doesn't require any outside kind of complicated infrastructure to see it be fulfilled. And then enter Genpact into the situation and their ability to kind of really see how a world works in this digital space and how to streamline it and make it efficient and fine-tune it, because that's really what we're striving for here. At the end of the day, when Adam and I talk about the long-term vision of Bento, it's to graduate people off of Bento and to get them to be members of society and to have their lives fulfilled and be happy and not have that constant stress. And when you start to look at a company like Genpact, who's really about these deep insights and how to create scenarios around a user experience and data to really generate a positive outcome, that's typically in the business world. Now, when you apply that to this massive social issue called food insecurity, I think you can see, you know, why we're so excited about what the outcomes might be.
Are you able to kind of consider people's nutritional needs and preferences, you know, that they might need for their own health outcomes?
Being able to start tailoring the nutritional criteria for all meals on our platform is becoming paramount for us. We want to be able to raise the bar in general. There's a high correlation between those that are food insecure with diabetes and obesity rates in our country. And so full stop, we want to make sure that we are doing everything we can to start bending the curve on that. And Genpact has amazing skills in machine learning and natural language processing, which are going to be deployed to a very specific use case that is high priority for us. It's going to create a lot of efficiencies, which is around being able to better and more efficiently curate healthy menu options.
We spoke with Sanjay Srivastava, Chief Digital Officer from Genpact, about how they can help Bento achieve their vision at scale.
What Genpact is doing is taking that platform and helping them expand into health outcomes, driving health outcomes. And you do that by not only serving meals, but by serving nutritious meals, by serving medically tailored meals for specific segments of their population. So very simply, what we do is this. We're building a dynamic intelligence platform. It's a platform that ingests the information that's required to make decisions. It applies matching algorithms and rule sets to be able to do the matching. So think about any matching service. And then it actually takes that and applies it to the orders that come through. In all of this, we're capturing the data. We're then able to use the data to match it against outcomes. And then you get to a point where you have evidence-supported approaches to how you deliver nutritious meals. And that's the outcome we're driving.
When you address medical conditions with food, all of a sudden you're getting to the core root of the problem. What are the ramifications that it would have on society as well as kind of the medical industry and the medical side of the world? The answer is massive.